it's Pam from the Shoots with Roots program at Milner Gardens and Woodland. And you'll have to excuse me, but I was just sitting here in the food garden at Milner Gardens eating my lunch. I've got some cucumbers, some carrots, some celery, all of which, you know, we've grown in this food garden. We call this area the food garden, of course, because we grow plants in this area that people like to eat as food. I was walking around earlier and I found peas. I found kale. I found radishes. I found lettuce. I even found a chive blossom with some bumblebees on it. And all of these plants could be my lunch right now if I wanted them to be. They're pretty tasty. But you know, that's got me to wondering that maybe it's time we talk about how plants get their food. We get a lot of our food from plants. My lunch today, it's completely made out of plants. But plants themselves, they can't go to the grocery store to get food. They don't pull up their roots and go walking around to another part of the garden to pick a plant to eat. Plants have to make all of their food themselves. So how can plants do that, you might wonder? How can plants make their own food? Well, it's through something called photosynthesis. And there are two main ingredients that plants need in order to make their food. One of those ingredients is water. The plants get the water from the soil. They draw it up from their roots and they get the water into themselves that way. The other ingredient is something called carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a gas and it's in our breath. So if I was to go and you could see my breath, you might see molecules of carbon dioxide in there. Which means this lettuce leaf gets the carbon dioxide it needs from the air and indirectly from me breathing. It gets the water it needs from the soil, and it can turn those two things, carbon dioxide and water, into sugar. That's right, plants can make sugar using just carbon dioxide and water. Wouldn't that be amazing? I'm green like a plant. I'd sure like to be able to go outside in the garden, and if I just had a little bit of water and air, start having my body physically, magically fill with sugar. That would be amazing. I'd probably be kind of hyper a lot of the time. But it doesn't work for me because I'm not a plant. To make this reaction happen, the plant needs two things. It needs chlorophyll, which is a chemical that works like it's a catalyst, basically, which is a big chemistry word, but it helps make the reaction happen. And it needs energy. It's just like if you bake cookies, you can put all the ingredients into the bucket and mix them together. The bucket? Do you make cookies in a bucket? Into a bowl and mix them together, and you've got cookie dough. But to turn them into cookies, you need to use the energy from your oven to bake them. Now, plants don't put the carbon dioxide and the water in an oven. They put it in something called a chloroplast. Now, a chloroplast is almost sort of like a factory inside of the plant. If we had a microscope and we looked up close at this lettuce leaf, we would see that this leaf right here is made up of a lot of tiny little cells. And inside each of those plant cells, we would see tiny little green blobs, and those are the chloroplasts. A chloroplast is filled with a stuff called chlorophyll, and it works like a plant food factory. The carbon dioxide comes in, and the water comes in, and then the last thing that happens is that energy from the sun powers this chloroplast the way electricity might power your oven, so that it can cause the chemical reaction to take place that changes the water and carbon dioxide into sugar. Now, just like some other chemical reactions, or when you make cookies and you end up with a lot of leftover dough stuck to the bowl, there's stuff left over from that reaction. And you know what it is? Oxygen. That's right. Not only is this amazing process of photosynthesis making us food that we can eat, it makes air, oxygen, for us to breathe. Our food comes from photosynthesis from plants, and so does some of the oxygen that we breathe to stay alive. So this is a pretty important process. That was a lot of science. I'm hungry. I'm gonna have my carrot, my hummus, and just, you know, appreciate all of the photosynthesis that had to happen for me to have my lunch. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.